I am so excited and so stoked for this video because it's all about them buns, hon. Top nuts, messy buns, donut buns, samurai buns, flour buns, a lot of buns. I'm excited. Today I'm bringing you another 10 short hairstyles featuring the buns. First thing first, I will need to add a little bit of texture from the middle to the ends of my hair because it is super soft and clean, and I'm using the Oribe Dry Texturizing Spray. So this bun is called the Samurai Bun or the Samurai Top Knot. All right, so I'm just gonna pick it up all of my hair as high as I can go. All right, so now that I have it in a high ponytail, you can take any hair elastic, you can use a clear elastic, but I'm gonna use something a little bit stronger and tighter, and this, I found these at Nordstrom. They're super pretty and they work amazing. So we're gonna go over the ponytail twice or three times, depending on how thick or thin your hair is. I'm gonna go about three times. And then on the very last time you're gonna go, you're just gonna pick up the hair and you're gonna not pull it all the way through, like about 3/4 of the way. So forget about the bun for a little bit. And if your hair is short as mine or even shorter, you're gonna have some hair left over. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna pick up these hairs, but make sure you use your mini bobby pins to do this because your hair is not that long or big to begin with. So we're gonna take one section and divide it into two, like in the back, just creating two sections. And we're gonna pick one section up first and then give it a little twist once you bring it to the top, and then pin it using the method that I taught you guys in my bobby pin video, where you kind of hide it, you tuck it, and then you hide it underneath. So going back up to the bun, so you see some hairs are a little bit too short and they're already falling out, so I'm gonna take them out, and we're gonna take this hair and we're actually going to wrap it around. Take your mini bobby pins, and this is why I love them so much, for these kind of like small detailing work. They're incredible, I can't live without them. Take the little bobby pins and then just start pinning the little sections away into the actual bun itself. So now that we have the initial shape and this is the size that I want, I don't go too big or too crazy. Once everything is nicely wrapped around, I go back in and take some of the hairs out so it's not so polished, because I think it looks better that way. So I'm gonna add a little bit of paste to my hair, kind of to smooth everything down and sleek it just a little bit. And I'm using the Bumble and Bumble BB Brilliantin. Brilliantin. And I'm just gonna work it in my hair as much as I need to. Bring some of these hairs down, like these little baby hairs that are growing back out. Just kind of let it frame my face. And there you have it from my rendition of the Samurai Top Knot or bun. Let me know if you actually already rock this type of look, but I love it just because it gives a nice slight rendition to my messy or like a regular top knot. Love this one. This next one I call the faux bun because we kind of fake it to make it bigger with like three different sections, and you guys will know what I mean. We're gonna start off with our hair again down. I'm gonna bring it right towards the back, meeting them in the middle and kind of creating like this half up do. So once you have your initial ponytail, take a clear elastic, tie it off once, a second time, pull it all the way through, and then the third time, I'm gonna pull it halfway, like that. So then we're gonna create three total sections, and we're gonna create kind of like a triangle in the back with those sections, how we tie it off. All right, so because we used clear elastics, they're gonna be showing from the sides and the top. You just wanna grab a little section from each section and just wrap it around the clear elastic and just tie it down or pin it down with the mini bobby pin. So now let's put these three sections together and create some type of top knot. I'm gonna take the lower left section and bring it up to the top section. Pull out some of the hairs, bring it up, and connect it with mini bobby pins. And just literally just go back and forth, top, bottom, the left, bottom together, and just create a little concoction with your mini bobby pins. If you have some baby or short hairs that are falling out, take your hair, put in your bobby pin, give them a quick twist going up, and just pin them right into your faux bun. What do we think of this faux bun that's really big, voluminous, and textured? I love this one in particular. It's really pretty. You kind of can get away with a lot shorter hair and to make it a nice big voluminous bun. I think it's fun. You can accessorize it, but this is a cool trick on how to get that really big bun. For the next bun technique, I call it the ponytail bun. I have no idea why. I will explain to you guys in the steps why I call it that. But I'm also gonna include a fun element to this top knot or bun, and I'm gonna include in braid. So braiding with top knots is really great, especially if you do like an upside down braid from the bottom to the top or the middle. This kind of includes the little hairs that you have in the back, and it doesn't have as much fallout as when you just pick it up towards the top and you pin it away. So I will have a lot of those links for you guys in the description box if you guys want to see a more full in-depth tutorial on how to do that. Those are so much fun. But today I'm gonna opt for the Dutch braid that kind of goes into a faux hawk to the little top knot right here at the top. So first you want to grab a section what you're gonna braid, and then just take the rest of the hair and just put it towards the back so you don't touch it. So like I mentioned, I'm gonna do a Dutch braid for this little faux hawk part at the very top. You can do a French braid, you can do a fishtail braid, you can do a faux braid. So a Dutch braid is when you take the sections, the outer sections, and you take them underneath the middle. So it's pretty much an opposite French braid. So what do you wanna do? Before you even pull this braid apart, we're just gonna pick it up into a top knot right here, right where the braid ends. Grab a clear elastic and just tie it off like two or three times so it's nice and tight into a ponytail. So once you have the ponytail, you're gonna start to kind of pull in your hair, making a really messy pancake towards like all sides of your head. Grab another clear elastic and just place it right in the middle on top of the hair, on top of the ponytail. So once you've created that like top knot bun or donut looking thing, and you have like these hairs left over, I'm gonna go back up to the bun and kind of take it apart just a little bit because my hair is already short and I don't wanna pull it out too much out of the clear elastic, and just start pinning the bun to the head. And here is my weird ponytail bun. I have no idea why I came up with that name. But I love this one, it's really quick, it's simple, and you can always give it a quick and different look with any braid. You can do one right here, you can do one in the back, like on the bottom. It's very simple, you can do some on the side. You can get really creative with this one because it's ridiculously easy and fast. Like I mentioned in the beginning, I will be using tools throughout this video, not all the time, but sometimes, to help create like that perfect flawless bun for the short hair especially. So this one, for this bun, I'll be using the Remington, the perfect half a bun. And that's exactly what we're gonna do. We're gonna do a half a bun, but kind of like an 80s style bun, because we're gonna take it on the side. But now like right here, just a little bit off centered. So you're gonna grab your half up ponytail, and then with your hands, they're like my favorite tools, with your hands, just bring your hair over to one side. Take your clear elastic and create a ponytail. So this right here is what the tool looks like, and I picked it up in the shade blonde since my hair is blonde. So it kind of looks like straight lips with curves, and then it has like this slit right down the middle. And this is where you can do, you're just gonna open up a little bit, just kind of open it up. What you're gonna do, take your hair and just bring it right through the middle. Make sure majority of the hair is brought through. Pick it up, straighten it out, and then we're gonna do is just twist it down, bring it towards the scalp, and then we're gonna bring them, these two edges, towards the middle like so. So they meet in the middle. And then to hide it, you're just gonna bring the rest of the hair towards the top, just kind of create like this donut looking thing. I'm gonna just take your bobby pins and then just secure the hair down. And I love this perfect half up bun just because it's so quick and simple, but yeah, it's very polished, it's beautiful, it's just the perfect bun. And then what I like to do, I like to take some more of the BB paste just to kind of smooth down my sides. You can also take some hairspray, but because I'm doing a lot of them today, I'm not gonna use that much hairspray, I'm just gonna use some of the paste so it's not gonna be too rough in my hair. And then what you can do, you can accessorize it like I am. I found these off of Amazon. If you like them, I will have them linked down below for you guys. What do we think of this one? It's kind of like a throwback to the 80s. I love it. The next bun method, I call it the twisted bun because you literally take your hair in like a ponytail and you twist it. So basically what you want to do is you grab your hair, all of it, or you can do like a half updo like what we just did. So once you have it in like a low ponytail, this is what you do. You just literally twist your hair in one direction and just make sure you kind of create it into a bun. That's why I call it the twisted bun. Just a quick tip, make sure you keep twisting it nice and tight around. Once it's twisted into a bun, take any hair elastic, I'm just using a clear elastic, and just secure it. You guys see why I call it the twisted bun? You literally twist it into a bun. I love this one, it's super simple, it's very sleek, and I actually like wearing it like this with like a hat on top, like a baseball cap. Just make sure you put it through the hole where the baseball cap connects. Also, I like to wear just like this, really nice and sleek. I will maybe pull like a cool little cuff around the actual bun because it's really tiny and polished. What else you can do is go back to the bun and loosen it just very gently around the edges, make it a little bit bigger, more voluminous, and then just secure it into your hair with like miniature bobby pins. But that's kind of the gist of it for the twisted bun. It's like a little baby bun, bambino. The next technique for the bun is using the do-it-yourself sock bun. We're not gonna do just one, we're doing two, because two is always better than one. So what you will need, because these buns are gonna be a little bit smaller than the regular one singular bun, you're gonna need two little ankle socks. And make sure you use socks that you're never gonna use again, or if you have mismatched socks, use both of them. And I only found these ones that I don't use, dark ones. I wish I had lighter ones, but I'll try to make them work in my blonde hair. And was I the only one growing up where you had like a huge bin of like mismatched socks?
Who had all socks matching?
Yes, that's a challenge right there. All right, so what you gotta do is, so you have the one side with the ankle where there's a hole. So where your toes are, you're gonna cut a hole right through. You're just gonna cut it straight through where the toes are supposed to be. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna roll the sock, creating like this mini donut. Yes, they're clean. They actually smell brand new. This right here is what it looks like. It just creates like this mini donut. So I'm just gonna divide my hair right in middle, since we're gonna do a little tribute to Star Wars Princess Leia right here with the two mini donuts. Or do-it-yourself sock buns. So I'm just grabbing my hair into two sections, and I'm gonna put them up both into little pigtails, like right here. Yes, it's gonna be attractive. So now that we have the two pigtails, make sure they're somewhat even, or you can be cool and crazy and do it uneven. So you take your sock buns, your do-it-yourself buns, we're gonna put it right through, and then we're gonna bring it up. I'm gonna kind of, this part gets a little bit tricky since you wanna make sure you pancake your hair flat all the way around. And then you just start rolling the hair. So you see, you roll it, you're gonna have some of these stray hairs. Don't worry about it, because we're gonna fix it. Do the same thing to the other bun. So we're gonna go check to make sure if we don't have any bald spots, and of course we do. So what you're gonna do, you're just gonna pull apart the hair. Kind of make sure it's going around the sock. Just gonna make sure all of it is covering. And then we're gonna start pinning the hair. So the dark navy sock actually worked pretty well in my favor, but for a future, I would actually do like a lighter brown or something like that to kind of match my hair. And there we have it for my double sock bun. Let me know if it actually sucks or if you like it. The next bun technique, I like to call it the tower bun. It's very simple. All you have to do is just wrap hair all the way up to the very top of the bun. It's really cool. Just pick up your hair into a very high ponytail or wherever you want your bun to be. So take your elastic and tie it off twice. And then on your very last time, when you're gonna tie off the ponytail, you're gonna bring it through about halfway, like that high up. So that way you have some hair left over. So what really makes this a tower bun is you have to take some hair out from like the sides. Just be really gentle so you don't take apart the entire thing. So just start taking hair out. I take at least about like six sections. They can vary in size. So just one, two. So now it looks kind of like a fountain in the front. I'm gonna take two bobby pins that are regular or long ones in size, and I'm gonna place them straight in the back, like so, right straight down, and kind of cover the hair around it, just to kind of keep the integrity of the actual bun so it just kind of stays straight up. So next, that these hairs that we didn't pull through to with the ponytail, I'm just gonna wrap them around the bottom, but you wanna don't do it too tight. And then pin it straight into the bun. So next, what you wanna do, all these little sections that I just took out, I'm gonna start wrapping them individually around the actual bun. And this is why I love mini bobby pins. They're so amazing for this kind of detail work. Love them. So all these sections, you can twist them in the same direction, or if you want a little bit more dimension, you can just take them in opposite directions like I am. Just play around with it and see what you like. All right, so now that it's nicely pinned and wrapped around, I think this one actually looks more like the samurai bun than the other one. But this one I like to call the tower because it looks like the Tower of Pisa. Well, the straight Tower of Pisa. So what you can actually do is, if you have a lot of hair left over, maybe do like a half updo instead of trying to pull all the hair up. But since my hair is a little bit longer, I'm gonna pick up the rest of this hair into little sections going towards the top and hide it with the mini bobby pins. And there we have it for the tower bun. Definitely not your average looking bun, you guys. I love this one, it's really fun. It's very, very, very edgy, and definitely wear it. You will definitely get a look or two. So the next method is to actually do the bun with a mini donut, or if you have a lot of hair, the big donut. Look at that difference. So the reason why I really like these preferred to the actual do-it-yourself socks is because this looks and feels kind of like a sponge. So for example, if you have some hair that's a little bit too short and you can't put it all the way around the bun or the sock bun, you can put it right into the actual bun. See the bobby pins? They go straight in and straight out, and they hold nice and tight because it has like a ton of holes, and it works very well. So I already have the ponytail. You wanna do it first, a ponytail, and then you wanna put the actual bun or donut through. And then what you wanna do, you wanna spread out the hair as evenly as possible, creating like this fountain of hair around the donut. Then whatever of the hair is left over, you're gonna wrap them around and then just pin it down. And then just clean up the rest of your hair. If anything needs to be pinned back, just pin it back. If you wanna braid the hair in the back, you can braid it. And this is why I love the mini donut bun, because it's extremely simple, it's really fast, and it's really cute, and it gives me that like ballerina vibe. And I don't know what else to say. I mean, it's very polished. If you want it super polished, just like take your sides, comb them down really nicely, spray your hair, spray whatever you do, and you're set to go within like a minute. The next bun technique, it's definitely different for everyone because it's just your simple, messy, go-to bun. This is kind of like what you do on your everyday basis, and this is just kind of what I do. I don't do all of my hair. I like doing this with kind of like a faux hawk section. So I just grab some hair from the front, and then just grab a clear elastic or any elastic that you're going to use, and then you're just gonna tie whichever bun you're gonna do. So I put it through once, like 3/4 of the hair, and then I bring it back and I just tie it off twice. Kind of gives it like a weird looking thing, and then just take the rest of the hair and then just pin it back down. So it kind of looks like a lazy samurai bun, but seriously, like every day is totally different. And this is why I like the messy bun. You can have fun with it. And there we have it for the perfect messy bun. I love this one, especially for those days where I wake up way too late. I go in the car and I just do it in the car. It takes like 30 seconds, not even. Just make sure you have like some bobby pins and maybe like a small little elastic on hand. But then you can get really fun with it. You can start accessorizing it, add some cute little braids. You can curl your hair, straighten your hair, do whatever you want. But I love the simplicity of this bun, and it's super cute. Last but not least for the bun technique, it's going to be a braided bun. One of my favorites. It's really cute. It's actually pretty simple, and there's a lot of different variations for this type of bun, but here is mine. Gather all of your hair and place it to where you want your bun to be sitting on your head. So I'm gonna do it quite high right here. I don't know if I even mentioned this. I'm using the Olivia Garden. I love this paddle brush. I get it from Ulta. It's amazing. It's very gentle. I love it. Once you have all of your hair gathered and placed where you want it to sit, just tie it off into a ponytail. So next, what I'm doing, I'm just grabbing sections from the ponytail and creating a 3-strand braid. I'm not adding hair to the braid, just a regular 3-strand braid. And you don't want to do the braid too tight since we're going to be pulling it apart towards the end. This is a good look. So now what we want to do is gently pull apart the braids, especially towards like where the ponytail starts. You want to get the braids nice and fat. Nice and juicy. And I actually have a total of 6 braids instead of 5. All right, so now that they're pulled apart nicely, I'm going to start wrapping the braids that are on the lower portion or lower section of the ponytail. And you don't want to wrap it too tight. And then once you wrap it to your desired destination, take the bobby pin and just pin it right into the ponytail. And I'm gonna pull it apart some more. So then you just kind of follow the procedure. So now let's actually put it together. When you have the initial shape of the bun, you're gonna start taking each braid to the other braid and just kind of take them together and just pin them with the little mini bobby pin into your ponytail. And then I'm just gonna go back in with the hair in the back that's just kind of chilling because it's too short. Just taking the mini bobby pins and just secure them going towards the top. And here is my finished braided bun for short hair. It's very possible. I've even done it with much shorter hair, like about to my chin. I just had to pin up my hair a lot more, or I would do like a half updo with the bun up here. I just love the texture it gives. It kind of looks like a flower. You can also like accessorize it, pull like cool little flowers around the entire bun, maybe like a scarf. You just do your own thing, put your own little spin on it. But I seriously love this one. And that concludes this episode for the 10 short hairstyles with different buns. I showed you guys different techniques, different methods, and then I implemented some hair tools as well to kind of make my life easier when I want to create that perfect bun. But I hope you guys like this video and hope it didn't discourage you guys. If you have shorter hair than I do, you can always implement braids, different twists to get your hair up into the bun. And I just hope you guys get inspired and try something different and new with your hair. But for now, thank you so much for watching this video. Comment down below with your favorite bun and what you like to wear on an everyday basis. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye.